Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to the last exercise video in this series, Advanced Development in Grasshopper. And actually, to be honest, it's not even going to be an exercise video because at this point in our course or seminar or playlist, whatever, I think we've gotten to a point where I think you know enough about how to build a full Grasshopper native plugin from scratch. So what I would like to do is I would like to invite you to practice doing that by taking all the components that we had prototyped as we were developing this video, all the prototypes that we had developed in C# scripting, and I would like you to do the exercise of porting those or rewriting those into a native component that looks something like this, where you cannot double click on the elements and where you probably will do the actual work of designing proper icons for each one. So what I've done here is in the native plugin that we have been developing, what I've done is I spent a live stream just like rewriting all these components, the simple ones, the utility and the vector ones, rewriting them into native components. And you can see that I was super lazy, so I just used the same icon over and over again for all of them. Hopefully you're a better designer than I am and you take the extra work of designing nice components for this. But I haven't done the rest of the other more interesting components, the nerves components, the data ones, dynamic simulation components, mesh, etc., etc. So what I would like to invite you to do is that if you're interested in practicing and if you're interested in doing in learning more, what I would like you is to just try to take the source code and try to take the project that I've been developing during this video and extend it to include and mimic all these components that we have here. What will be interesting about this exercise is that most of the code, or all the source code, you can already see it from the C# prototypes, although some minor tweaks might need to be done in order to do this whole thing. So you will have to do a little bit of like handling the inputs and the outputs, defining for each component what types you want in the manager, in the inputs and the outputs, etc., etc. You may want to include your custom icons. You may want to break down the order in which these components show up on the first block, second block, third block of each category. And maybe even for the components that are more data intensive, you may need to do some translations between how data is handled in C# script and data is handled in native, which we already discussed in a previous video. So I'm not going to show you how I did this. It's long and boring, and I actually spent most of the live stream fixing this bug that I couldn't track down for development with this file. And so if you're interested in seeing and learning how I very, very quickly copy-pasted and implemented all these components, there will be a link to the live stream where I did this just popping up as a card, hopefully somewhere in the corner. And perhaps there will be a link in the description of this video if you want to go through the entire, if you want to see me struggle through that bug. And if you want to see me like really quickly copy and paste things from the C# scripts to native components, okay? I think this will be a really good exercise. It will help you practice. It will be easy. You can just grab coffee while you're doing this because it will be fairly mechanical, but it will teach you some of the nitty-gritties and get you practice into some of the nitty-gritties of how to design components natively so that when you develop your own component and your own plugin, you have that muscle memory already built into yourself, okay? So here's my invitation. Please go ahead, do some homework, practice, and develop the rest. If by the time you watch this video far, far into the future, you go to the repo and you see that all the components have been developed, I would like to thank anyone in the community who may have taken the repo and do push requests and expanded all these components and do the work for us, all right? Maybe that person is you. Maybe that person is someone who takes this code, writes it, and then just pushes it to the repository where we currently have this. Remember that the repo for the plugin and these sample files is also in a link in the description of this video. All right? If you do it, and if you do something cool, make sure to let me know somehow. Social media, direct messages, ParametricCamp Discord server, that was definitely going to be the best way to do this, all right? And I will make sure to thank you properly and to broadcast your work with the rest of the community, okay? Beautiful. And let's move on to the last videos in this playlist in advanced development in Grasshopper, okay? See you in the next video. Bye-bye.